Hello everyone, today's topic is integral domains. Here in this video I am going to explain you about the topics are definition of an integral domain, definition of a field, definition of characteristic of a ring and related theorems on these three definitions. First, moving to the definitions. Definition of an integral domain. A ring r comma plus comma dot is said to be an integral domain if r has commutative property, that is a dot b equals to b dot a for all a comma b belongs to r. The second condition, it should have a unity element 1 belongs to r such that a dot 1 equals to 1 dot a equals to a. The third condition, it should have without zero divisors property, that is ab equals to 0, then either a equals to 0 or b equals to 0. If r satisfies these three conditions, then we can say r is an integral domain. Now moving to the next definition, field. A ring r comma plus comma dot is said to be a field if r has a unity element, that is a dot 1 equals to 1 dot a equals to a. The second condition, it should have a multiplicative inverse, that is a inverse equals to a inverse a equals to 1. The third condition, it should have a commutative property, that is a dot b equals to b dot a for all a comma b belongs to r. If r satisfies these three conditions, then we can say r is a field. Now next, moving to next definition, characteristic of a ring. The characteristic of a ring is defined in the form of nx equals to 0, where n is a least positive integer and it is denoted by char r. Now moving to the theorems on these three definitions. Theorem 1, every finite integral domain is a field. Proof, let take an element r be a finite integral domain. If r is finite, then set r will contain finite elements, so r equals to a1 comma a2 so on up to an, take that as equation 1. Now, then by definition of integral domain, we have R is commutative as well as R has no zero divisors. Now, to prove R is a field, it is enough to show that R has multiplicative inverse. Why? Because by the definition of integral domain, R has commutative and it has a unity element. So, it is only enough to prove a multiplicative inverse. Now let take an element a not equals to 0 belongs to r. Then from equation 1 you multiply a on both sides, then ar equals to a into a1 comma a into a2 so on up to a into an. Now just assume that the elements in ar are equals to one another, that is a into ai equals to a into aj for I not equals to j. Now you take the right side element to the left side, a into ai minus a into aj equals to 0. The next step, you take a as common, then a into ai minus aj equals to 0. Now a equals to 0 is not possible. Why? Because already we took the condition a not equals to 0. So we can equate only ai minus aj equals to 0. The next step, we will get ai equals to aj, which is contradiction since we took I not equals to j. By this contradiction, we can say the elements in ar are not equals to one another. And also we can say and every element of r must be equal with exactly one of the element in ar. That is, If A belongs to R, then same element A will also belongs to AR. And AR elements in, is in the form of A into AK. And A belongs to AR and the AK belongs to AR. Then we can equate A equals to A into AK. Take this as equation 2. Now, if R has unity element, that is, if it is unity, 1 will exist, that is, 1 belongs to R, then same element 1 will belongs to the AR. Take this as equation 3. Now, let take an element AI be any element in R, then A into AI equals to 1. This we got from the equation 2 and 3. Since R is commutative, we can write A into AI as A into AI equals to AI into A equals to 1. Since is in the form of inverse property, we can write inverse of A is AI. Therefore, R has a multiplicative inverse. Hence, we can say R is a field. Now, next, moving to the next theorem. Characteristic of an integral domain is either 0 or prime. Proof. Let take an element R is an integral domain. We have to prove characteristic of R is either 0 or prime. Let we are taking the characteristic of R as P. Now we have to show P is a prime. Now, in the contradiction way, assume that P is not a prime. Now, P is not a prime means the P will be a composite number. Then, I am taking the P equals to product of two elements P1 into P2, where P1, P2 lies between 1 and P. Now, take an element A not equals to 0 belongs to R. By closure property, we can write A into A belongs to R. In the next step, we will get A square belongs to R. Since we took the characteristic of R is P, then by definition of characteristic, we can write P into A square equals to 0. In the next step, you substitute in the place of P as P1 into P2 into A square equals to 0. In the next step, you write P1 into P2 and write A square as A into A equals to 0. And the next step, split the form P1 into A into P2 into A equals to 0. Now, we can equate P1 into A equals to 0 separately and also P2 into A equals to 0 separately. Now, I am taking if P1 into A equals to 0. Now, compare this formation with the definition of characteristic. Here, the characteristic of R will be a P1. But this is a contradiction because already we took the characteristic of R is P. Next case, you take P2 into A equals to 0. Again, this also you compare with the definition of characteristic. Here, the characteristic of R will be a P2. But this is also contradiction to our assumption because the characteristic of R is P. Therefore, the characteristic of R is P, where P is a prime. What we have assumed P is not a prime is wrong. P is a prime number. Hence, the characteristic of an integral domain is either 0 or prime. Hope you all have understood. Thank you.